Welcome. Welcome. You're all welcome. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We made it 2020, man. We made it through 2020. And it's been a hell of a year, man. COVID. I'm just glad we made it through. Outside of all the terrible things that happened in 2020, man, a lot of dope music dropped in 2020. And I just wanted to come on here, man, and give y'all my favorite albums of 2020, my top 10 favorite albums of 2020. And without further ado, we're going to get right into it, man. My number 10 album this year comes from D-Smoke. It's called Black Habits.
Ain't a dollar sign tag on some peace of mind, Jack. We could take a loss, we gon' get it right back. We could take a loss, we gon' get it right.
He got nominated for a Grammy with this one, which caught me off guard, I ain't gonna lie. I didn't think he would get a Grammy nod for that. But the album was dope, man. Despite the Kendrick similarities, I know a lot of people compare him to Kendrick or say he biting off Kendrick or whatever. Despite all of that, I would say that this was a pretty dope project. And I recommend that if y'all haven't heard it yet. That's Black Habits by D-Smoke. And let's go on to number 9 is an album by Bobby Sessions called Revolution, Chapter 3, The Price of Freedom.
Reparations with 40 acre plant seed for food. You keep the mule, teach the youth to work day and night. Invest your time, protect your life.
Yo, this was a big album for me, like an enjoyable album for me. Kind of remind me of Dead Prez, you know, with his content, you know, being very, you know, revolutionary rap, but modernized. You know, you could tell that he's younger, you know what I mean? I think he's from like Dallas, Texas or something, but it's a perfect soundtrack for 2020, man. Y'all go out and check that one. Moving on, number 8 is an album by T-Mar, Before I Spill Myself.
You wild with it.
This got to be one of the most entertaining albums of the year for me. I would call this Keep It A Buck R&B. You know what I'm saying? Because she don't really sugarcoat nothing. And you best believe she earned that parental advisory sticker straight up. You know what I mean? Let's move on to number 7. It's an album from Lyric Jones, Closer Than They Appear.
I rock on, been building my path. Yeah, it's cobblestone, still I get my walk on. Been kind of bumpy along the way, and still I'm not gone.
This is another surprising album for me. I actually learned about this album and learned about her. I was scrolling on IG, and I stumbled upon Fonte's IG. And he was kind of promoting her album a little bit, so I was like, you know, Fonte rock with it, you know what I mean? It's got to be dope, you know what I'm saying? So I trusted Fonte on that. And as soon as I hit play, I got major Lil Brother vibes. And if you know me, I'm a big Lil Brother head. So, you know, it brought that back for me. And the album is dope all the way through. Number 6 is Freddie Gibbs and Alchemist, Alfredo.
Microphone check, 1, 2, mic checker. Still back that blood out, that's a banana, I pray to Mecca. All this gang shit in my brain, I got the rank, I got the best.
Freddie, man, he been on a crazy run as of late, the past couple years. Alfredo is just keeping that momentum going, you know what I'm saying? That he started with Bandana, which I thought was a better project than this one. But, this one actually got a Grammy nomination as well. So big up to Freddie Gibbs and Alchemist on the Grammy nom. Alfredo is definitely one of the top hip-hop albums of 2020, so it's well-deserved. Number 5, Benny the Butcher, Burden of Proof.
50,000 in a draw at the W with some bitches. And every time I score, it's a W for the villains. I'm somewhere in the hood, elbow rubbing with all the dealers. Same.
I ain't gonna lie, when I first heard that Benny and Hit-Boy was collabing on the album, I was kind of worried because I just didn't know how that sound would mesh. I'm so used to hearing Benny over those real grimy New York beats. I just didn't know how it would work. But like halfway through track one, you know, I was so like none of those worries existed, man. Like Hit-Boy and Benny, that equals classic material. So this is definitely a highlight of 2020. Album number 4. Conway the Machine, From King to a God.
I did a lot of shit that I regret. Yeah. I've done a lot of things I can't take back.
Hands down, this is Conway's best project
easily from start to finish, man. The diversity in production was needed, and I thought it came off real dope. He actually had a Hit-Boy track on there, a DJ Premier track. Like, he, Just Blaze, I believe. Like, he worked with a bunch of different producers, and the sound was just amazing, in my opinion. Like, I used to go back and forth about who's the best MC in Griselda. Conway just took his spot, man. Album number 3 from Teyana Taylor, called The Album.
Wake up, love. These sheets won't comfort me. Please wake up, love.
This is the one, you know what I'm saying? It's easily my favorite R&B album of the year. She didn't get a Grammy nomination for this album. I really don't understand why. But it don't matter, man. It's a crazy, crazy album, man. Just she must have felt a certain way about that last joint. That last album with Ye, where she had to give him 7 songs. Cause like on this one, she hit us with like 23 bangers. You know what I'm saying? It's a long album, man. So get ready. Number 2, Royce da 5'9", The Allegory.
We got Primo on them cuts. We got Pino in them cups. Contraband and quarter panels, 4 or 5 kilos by the struts.
Royce could probably get Lyricist of the Year pretty much every year. But the last few projects he's put out have been album of the year worthy. He's really putting together dope ass projects, you know what I'm saying? What I love most about this project is that Royce produced the entire thing himself. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's big. I didn't even know Royce made beats. You know what I'm saying? I think this is like his first crack at producing. And for him to produce an entire project of his own and for it to come out and sound the way it sounds and for him to get nominated for a Grammy for that, like, that's crazy bananas, man. Shout out to Royce. I salute Royce, man, on making one of the best albums of 2020. And the number one album, in my opinion, of 2020 goes to Nas, King's Disease.
I used to be at the tunnel, 20 deep in the huddle, razors on us that'll make skin bubble, more wet we guzzle, Chris Lighty lit me in.
Yo, I've been waiting for a album like this from Nas for a while. This is another album that was produced entirely by Hit-Boy. And it seemed like Hit-Boy gave Esco all the heat. Like, he laced him with, like, the cream. Like, he was like, yo, this is my best beats ever. Here, go ahead. You pick from those. You know what I'm saying? But from start to finish and back again, I mean, the album had heavy replay value for me. 100% classic material. And that's my number one favorite album of 2020. Y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments. If y'all agree with my favorite albums of 2020, y'all don't have to. And let me know what y'all think, man. Who were your favorite albums of 2020? Doesn't necessarily have to be hip hop, obviously. But this has been Black Sun's World. Thank y'all for joining me. Hit the subscribe button. And until next time, man.
It's the one with the golden smile and the fire pen. They want me done. Here's your refund. I try again.